Georgia risks sliding into Russia's orbit. The country may become another Belarus. Katia Dekanoidze, head of Russia's parliamentary opposition, spoke in an interview with NV Radio about the controversial foreign agents bill and the threats it poses to Georgia. If the bill passes, it may create a barrier to Georgia's EU and NATO aspirations, according to Dekanoidze. Georgian citizens, especially the younger generation, call this bill Russian because Russia had the same past one in 2012, she said. They recognized as foreign agents such people as Alexei Navalny, Ivan Zadanov, who were then either killed by Russian President Vladimir Putin or they left Russia. Therefore, I think that what awaits Georgia is, if the bill is passed, is becoming another Belarus, where people realize that no democracy can take root. If the parliament supports the bill in the third reading, the Georgian people's resistance will be very serious, Dekanoidze suggested. I'm sure that Georgians won't live under a dictator like Belarusian President Alexander Lukashenko, she said. It's not a question of domestic politics. It's a question of where we're going. I'm absolutely certain that the oligarch who controls the ruling Dream Party, Bidzina Ivanishvili, wants to take over Georgia just like, but I don't think he'll get away with that. After the Georgian government submitted another draft of the bill to the parliament in April, mass protests against the controversial legislation have taken place across the country. Georgia's parliament gave initial approval to a bill on foreign agents that the European Union said risked blocking the country's path to membership. The fate of the bill is widely seen as a test of whether Georgia, 33 years after the collapse of the Soviet Union, intends to pursue a path of integration with the West or move closer towards Russia. As many as 10,000 opponents of the bill gathered outside the parliament, sitting atop cars and buildings a day after police used pepper spray to clear protesters away from part of the building. Several thousand protesters moved over to the government building, heavily guarded by police, to demand a meeting with Prime Minister Irakli Kobakidze, the bill's principal backer.
A total of 400 to 500 missiles and drones will be fired at Israel from Iran, Iraq, Syria, southern Lebanon and the Houthis, ABC News outlet reported, citing an unnamed U.S. official. The source said that the bulk of missiles will be launched from the territory of Iran. The drones are the same kind used in Ukraine, according to the source. Meanwhile, U.S. media also report that President Joe Biden will address the nation from the Oval Office today. According to the latest reports, Biden has already arrived in the Oval Office. Israeli Defense Forces reported on Saturday night that Iran launched drones and cruise missiles at Israel. Amid the escalation of the tension in the region, Egypt, Yemen, Iraq closed their airspaces. Meanwhile, U.S. Air Force fighter jets have been scrambled over Iraq and Jordan to combat Iranian drones, the Al Qahira Alek Baria TV channel reported.
هذا من المقاومة هذا شوف 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 جايين طلقان جايين طلقان هاي منا 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 هلا بيهن هلا شوف 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 هلا بيهن هلا 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 بيهن وين ما يطيحن خي يطيحن اضرب ولا تبالي اضرب يا مهدي
صاروخ إيراني صاروخ إيراني
بس طيح
هاي درونات هاجم والله وانا بس خلي اشوف ذاك 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 يا عمو يا هذي
هذا عجب على واحد اسرائيلي بدهره
ابو هاي درونات من الناصري
هاي اسرائيل
هذا
اثنين
هذا ثاني واحدة
شنو هاي؟ مال اليوم ضرب اسرائيل هسه يردون عليها اسرائيل من هناك واحنا نصير بالنص من عليها